Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. So it's the 1st of October today, and that means this is the month of Halloween, so I thought we would kick off the beginning of this month with a Halloween tutorial, how to do a text blood drip effect, all done inside of DaVinci Resolve 17 and using Fusion. Also, I did something similar last year, but in that tutorial I used real blood, and you can see how to do that tutorial right up here if you are interested. Also, if you need to make some fake blood, I did do a tutorial on how to do fake blood as well, and you can have a look at that right up here as well. Also, if you are new to this channel and want to learn DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks and want to have a look at some pretty cool gear, I would recommend you to subscribe. Also, join the Facebook group to make a great community over there. And if you want to become a member of the YouTube channel, push the join button down below. Well, with that out of the way, let's get right to this tutorial. Okay, so let's get started with doing this Halloween blood effect. And first thing, we're going to the effects library. We'll go into our effects and we're just going to drag down a fusion composition. And with that done, let's go into Fusion. Alrighty, so first up, we are going to add in a background. And in this case, it's just going to be a very standard black background. Then we're going to take in our text tool here, and I'm just going to add that in right here. And in the text tool, I'm just going to write Halloween very fast. I did copy paste that, but okay. And then I'm going to change my font to a Friday the 13th font. I think that could be great. And for this thing, we're just going to make this a little bit larger, like that. Something like this. And that is a good starting point. However, I am going to highlight my text and I'm going to Control C and Control V to doing a copy of that. And I'm just going to drag down another merge node and going to connect this right here. And then I am going to change the color of that to red. So this is what we have. Now I just want to do a little bit of an animation as well. So I'm just going to take in a, let's just take a rectangle here. I'm going to put this right in here. And with the rectangle selected, I'm going to change the width of that. So it'll fill the entire title. And it's just going to, I'm going in the height here, I'm just going to change that just slightly a bit so it will fill the whole thing. Okay, so what I want to do now is actually, I'll go to the beginning here of the timeline with the polygon selected. I'll go into the center and I'm going to go to the YX and moving up the red color. And then I'm just going to put in a keyframe. And let's say we're going to go like 10 frames forward, and after that, the text will become red, like that. So now we have this effect here, go here, something like that. So what I want to create now is, I want to create drops of blood running from some of the letters, and let's see how we're going to do that. So first off, I'm going to take a background. Again, I'm going to change the color to red. I will need a merge node, so I'm just going to drag a merge node down yet again. And in this case, I'm just going to take the polygon mask here and connect that to the background. And I'm just going to select my background and push 1 so I can see what I'm doing. So let's say I want something to, you know, run from the H. So I'm just going to make some kind of a line. Like that. Then I'll go over here and I'm going to check this box with the solid off. And now I'm going to the border width. And you know, I can change the border of
blood here, so it'll be a little thicker. So we have the animation going here. Something like that. So maybe I want it to run around here. In this case, I'm going to put this all the way back to zero. I'm going to put in a keyframe, going with my arrow keys a couple of frames forward. Let's say 3, 4, 5 frames forward. And then I want my length here to change to this. So if we have a look at what we have now, we should have some kind of an animation. And I do think, if we check the polygon, that this is a little too extreme. So I want to change this to some smaller little blot here in the board width. And when that's done, I'm going to connect this as a foreground. And now we have a blot running like that. So let's have a look here. There's a little thing because I don't want the blot to be here from the beginning, of course. So I'll need to fix that as well. I'll do that in the merge node. So in the merge node, I'll go into the blend mode. I'm going to push the blend mode all the way down. So it should be off. I'm going to put in a keyframe. And, you know, I'll go for to around here. And I'm going to put in a keyframe, go one frame forward, and then I'm just going to turn the blend mode up. So this is what we have. Still, I think it's a little too thick and a little too cartoonish. So I will go back again to the polygon. I'm going to take the border width, put it down a little bit more. And you know, I could use the soft edge as well to make it a little softer. But be careful with the softness, because now it looks more like graffiti, and that's not what I was going for. So I'm going to take down the soft edges even more. It's going to be almost nothing, something like this. Yeah, so this is the effect here. And of course we can change that as well. We can go and make this a little longer. Okay, so that is how you do the basic of this effect. You know, you could do the same thing by copying the polygon here. I'm just going to copy a polygon, Control Z, Control V. And in this case, we're just going to take another background. We're going to connect the background, and we're going to change the color of the background to red. And then we have this polygon here, but we don't want to use that yet. So we're going to move this and put it around here. And maybe we want to do some changes to that as well. Maybe we want it to be a little more bendy or something like that. So we can change it so it doesn't look like the exact same thing. I'm going to add in another merge node. And, you know, I'm going to add this on top of the merge as a foreground. And here we have that. So the only thing that's changed now is see the way it moves. So we can do blot effects like that inside of DaVinci Resolve 17's Fusion. And, you know, it's not a bad effect. It's a pretty easy effect to pull off as well. And you can, of course, use way more time of making the blots look way cooler than I did. So if you do that, let me see how your blot text looked. Link down in the description with your video. I would love to see what you come up with. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.